Alright, let's jump in and make a program. We'll start from absolutely nothing, and by the end, it'll be pretty awesome, like a mini drawing program. Think of this as a whirlwind tour through the first few lessons on Khan Academy, just to give you a sense of what's possible. Don't worry at all about understanding every little detail right now. We just want to give you a sense of what's ahead and the sort of programs you're going to be able to make before long. So right now, there's nothing here, which is kind of lame, so let's draw something. I'm going to draw an ellipse, which is a circle-like thing. And as you'll learn, here's how I do that. And there it is, which is kind of magical. The reason is that there are a few special things that the Khan Academy environment already knows about, and lucky enough, ellipse is one of them. Don't worry about what all these numbers mean. You'll learn about them in Intro to Drawing. Still, here's a sneak preview. As we change the numbers, we can see that the first one basically means how far across, the second one basically means how far up and down, the third one seems to mean how big across, and the last one, how big up and down. Again, you don't need to know that right now, but you can pause this talk if you like and play around with it yourself right now. You're going to learn all the details in later lessons, and the important thing for now is just that they control what the shape looks like. Okay, so that's nice, but you're probably not very impressed. So I'm going to do something that looks a little bit more complicated, and then put that ellipse that we made right inside. Okay, so nothing changed, and you're probably still not very impressed. But now what I'm going to do, and the output I think will be a little bit more impressive, is make this program animated. And now as you can see, there's tons of circles, and they're actually following my mouse around as I move it. You can pause the program right now and have it follow your mouse instead. Okay, so how is this even happening? Where are all these circles coming from? Well, you'll learn about all this in Intro to Animation later, but since you're wondering, what's happening is that the computer tells our program automatically, over and over and over again, draw, 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 draw. And you might think that our program will get tired of that, but instead it just keeps doing what's inside this magic draw part. So it just keeps drawing ellipse after ellipse after ellipse. And that's what's going on behind the scenes when we wave our mouse around to make so many ellipses, even though we just wrote it once. So how does the program know where to draw the ellipse? For example, like how does it know to draw it following the mouse? Well, so you'll learn about that in mouse interaction later on. The big idea is that each time, the computer also tells our program where the mouse is using these two special mouse words, mouse X and mouse Y. You don't need to know about them for now, but mouse X is just how far over the mouse is, while mouse Y is how far up and down. So, just to recap, when we make this ellipse, what we're saying is that the first one says, draw the ellipse as far across as the mouse is across, and the second one says, draw the mouse as far up and down as the mouse is down. And what that ends up meaning is, draw an ellipse in the exact same place as the mouse is every single time we say, draw. And then these last two just say what size the ellipse should be. And again, don't worry about all these details for now. After you go through the next few lessons, this will make a lot more sense. And now, as you can see, this is getting a little bit cluttered, and we can just click this restart button to start the program over again with a blank slate. Go ahead and pause the program right now and play around with it yourself, just so you can see what's happening. Okay. So now we have something kind of neat going on. But what else could we do? Well, these circles sure are kind of ugly. They're just white. So what if we can make them colored? There's a whole intro to coloring tutorial where you'll learn all about colors, but I'm going to ruin the secret and show you how to do it right now. Ta-da! Sweet! Now we have red circles following the mouse, but they don't only have to be red, because when you click this color here, you can see for yourself when you do it that you can choose any color you'd like, a whole rainbow of colors. So how about just a nice purple one right now? And you can learn about why the colors change when you do that intro to coloring. So once we restart, we can, great, we only have purple circles. So now we might think, you know, we put in all this work to draw these beautiful shapes whenever we move the mouse. But really, it'd be nice to draw just sometimes, like just when the mouse is pressed. And I'm going to show you how to do that now. Logically, it's not that complicated. All we're really saying is, if the mouse is pressed, draw the circle. Otherwise, don't do anything at all. So here's how we happen to say that in code. Say if, and then these weird parentheses that you don't need to worry about. So if mouse is pressed, and then what do we want to do when the mouse is pressed? Well, we just want to draw our ellipse. And otherwise, we just don't really want to do anything, so we'll leave this part down here all blank. So when we restart it, we can say, I'm moving my mouse around, nothing's happening, But when I press the mouse, I can draw in purple and write things and draw things and pretty much, you know, do whatever I want, which is kind of neat because in just a couple lines of code, we made this little drawing program. So there's an entire intro to if statements tutorial where you'll learn all about what this code does that we just wrote and how it works, but I bet you can start to see the general idea already. All we're saying is if the mouse is pressed, do this, and otherwise, if the mouse isn't pressed, we just won't do anything. Cool. That's the exact same logic we had in our head. We just wrote it in code now. And you might point out, like, what about this ugly outline around all our circles? Well, you'll learn how to control that soon. You can make it bigger, you can make it smaller, you can make it different colors. But for now, honestly, I just want to get rid of it. So I'll just put no stroke at the top here because that little outline's called a stroke. And now, when we restart it, hey, the stroke's all gone. Perfect. This looks like a much more realistic drawing program. So let's just quickly take a step back. You might be curious, where are all these magic abilities like if and ellipse and draw coming from? These useful commands are built into Khan Academy. We did that. And the fun part comes from learning how to combine them into programs. If you're really curious, we're using a language called JavaScript on Khan Academy. JavaScript is one of the most popular ways to write programs in the world, especially on the internet, so you'll be in pretty good company. So we made this cool drawing program, but that doesn't mean at all that it's completely done. You can pause this program and customize it however you like. You can change the circle size, you can change the color, and when you've made it beautiful, you can save it as a spin-off via this button down here and show it to everybody you know. But I bet you can imagine lots of ways to make this program better that you don't know about yet, you know, beyond just changing the colors and the size. Maybe you want to make a cool animation with penguins, or a fun game, or just something neat for your friends and family. Well, you're in the right place, because if you stay with us, you're on track to learn how to do all that and more with code. So I hope you thought that was kind of neat. If you did, you know, go ahead and upvote. Making this little drawing program only took us a few minutes, but we learned a little bit more about how code works. The next few lessons are about diving deeper and learning exactly what we just did here so that it doesn't all look so mysterious. We're going to start right at the beginning and build our way up through the basics, and in just a little bit, believe it or not, this will be no big deal. Actually, if you keep going, pretty soon you're going to be able to do things far beyond this little program.